Okay, stage two. Turn your fabric inside out. And we are going to have to break into this now, because obviously this needs to be amended before it's going to be stitched back on. Can I have your measurement guide, please? Break down your measurements. So from the bottom length of where you want the drop to go to, up to the waist area, take a measurement and write that measurement down. Now what we have is we have the measurements going the other way for our measurement. So the full length of the...
This is 40.
Right, so if... Yeah, full length of the dress, we require it... Did she want it 45?
She wants it proper to her ankles.
To her ankles, so she wants it 45. Yeah. So 45 minus, can I just have the dress? I don't have the actual person that we're making this for here. So what we're going to do is measure her, did she measure the waist length?
I think 41 should be okay, 45 would be too long.
Right. Well, if we measure it, like if we measure it with her dress, right, yeah. And if we measure the waist length, yeah. The narrowest part on this very fitted dress is round about here, and if we measure the length from the top of the shoulder to the narrowest part, it's about 12 inches. Yeah. So, if we break this down first, which is 12 from the top, and if we want 44 in total, so we want 32 inches. So measuring down from here upwards, 32. So on each of your kali, you need to measure up to 32 and just mark it out, and then these, each one of these then needs to be opened up from the top downwards. Okay, the next stage then is, once you've opened these up, you need to take a section of this off to give it a shape. Okay. Right. So I'm going to give this to my assistant to actually open it up to here, and then once we've opened it, we're going to slightly narrow all these panels down so we can give it shape, and then reattach these back up, because that's the only way we're going to get the waist area to come in and to make it look more like the anarkali shape. Okay, so that's stage one, to measure from where you required the length of the dress up to the waist area, and then the waist area, this about 8 inches of this will need to be narrowed quite a bit for the waist, and then left slightly wide for the bust area, and sort of slightly shaped again on the upper shoulder area.
Yeah.
Okay, so if you unpick, if you measure, what I'll do is I'll give you this, right? Each one of the panels, just measure it to 32 inches,
okay.
And just put a chalk mark, and then open it from the top downwards.
Yeah.
Okay? Now, in the meantime, I'm just going to do a small explanation on the...
I'd like the measuring.
You can take the ruler.
You not need this.
No, I'm all right. There should be some tape measures around as well.
Chalk, any more chalk?
Just
take that
there. Just take that.
So 31 inches.
32 inches. Okay, so this is the back of the dress, and this is the front. The making of this is fairly simple, but what we've got to decide is, do we want to leave this small area of the unembroidered part as it is, or do we want to add a piece of fabric from the dress to make it look like... Personally, my preference would be to add a piece of the turquoise fabric, so that that looks like... This looks like embroidery that's been done on top of the dress, not that this part got left empty by the embroidery. So these are just small things to bear in mind when making something like this. Obviously, if you were making it sleeveless and like this, then what I would do is I would do this with lining underneath, and just basically attach, once the kaliyan are stitched back up, attach them here, attach lining on the inside, which would make it very simplified and very easy to do. Unfortunately, our dress is going to be slightly different, although the attaching is going to be still remain the same. I'm going to add small pieces that we're going to get out from the salwar fabric and hopefully go and teach you that as we go further along. I think we need the kalyan doing first before we do anything else. So